I have a dream.
Just a few days shy of the Martin Luther King Jr. National Holiday, the National Press Club in Washington invited his niece Alveda to talk about today's civil rights issues. She spoke of visiting Ferguson in the midst of rioting and noting this wasn't necessarily a black versus white issue.
It's like a tale of two cities, a violent upheaval with outside agitators. People don't live there, coming in bombing stores and blowing up things. And I said, I bet you the people who live in Ferguson are home by 10 o'clock at night.
King's somewhat of a civil rights activist herself, but not one with the usual liberal viewpoints. For instance,
we have seen increasingly more and more people in Ferguson who say, let's do this thing peacefully. We don't need to riot. Tearing up the city won't make it better.
What's interesting is this woman, whose famous uncle died in one of the most infamous shootings in American history, has a fairly conservative stand on gun control.
Every time someone has been shot throughout our history by guns, the first thing is take up all the guns. Remove the guns. If you take away the guns, you stop the violence. That's not true, because in the first place, if there were a real movement to take all the guns, then all the mean and evil and crooked people would find ways to keep them and hide them, and all the good people would give up the guns. So that would immediately be unbalanced.
She says you can't solve violence in the human heart by impounding weapons.
We've got gun control, now we're going to do choke control? I'm going to beat you to death with my fist control? I'm going to poison you control?
King said her famous uncle and some of his supporters considered using guns in the civil rights battle, but decided they'd be so outgunned they could never win in an armed struggle. Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from the National Press Club.